Today we'll discuss why California's personal income tax revenue is so volatile compared to its personal income. Here we see the annual percent change from 1990 to 2014 of personal income in blue, and in red we have the change in income tax revenue adjusted for policy changes. Personal income is much more stable. Here's personal income by itself. The state doesn't tax some components of personal income, such as Social Security. When you take these out, the taxable pieces are a bit more volatile. The taxable parts of personal income still are not as volatile as the amount of income subject to the tax, which is called adjusted gross income. The reason is because the state taxes some things that are not included in personal income, such as capital gains. To show capital gains, we need to extend the range of this graph from negative 60% at the bottom all the way up to a 100% increase at the top. Capital gains are a small share of income, but they add a lot of volatility. Revenue is still much more volatile than adjusted gross income. Why? One reason is because the state imposes a graduated rate structure that taxes higher levels of income at higher rates. As we see here, the income of filers under $150,000 a year doesn't change much from year to year, while income of filers over $150,000 varies a lot. The state relies more on the volatile part of its tax base than on the stable part. Finally, some of the volatility comes from deductions and credits. In 2014, filers over $150,000 had about as much income as filers under $150,000. But the filers under $150,000 got nearly 80% of the deductions. This shrunk the stable piece of the tax base much more than it shrunk the volatile piece. With credits, it was the same story. About three quarters went to filers under $150,000. So, we estimate that about 40% of the additional volatility came from differences between personal income and the income tax base. Another 40% came from the state's graduated rate structure, and the final 20% came from deductions and credits.